Cyberpunk on a $100 GPU? Has Intel unlocked some secret forbidden knowledge or delved deep into some ancient tomes? They may not be transmuting lead into gold, but together with Asrock, they've taken their silicon into a golden direction. I'm not sure what kind of arcane magic Intel has been weaving, but the Arc Alchemist GPUs have shaken up the GPU option landscape, especially when you start looking at options for graphic cards priced at around $300 and below. And when I say $300, I don't mean $299. I mean they are GPUs in the family priced as low as $100. What? Okay. Now you might be asking, are you insane, Robey? What can you even get for this price? Well, I'm glad you asked because we have been asking the same question. And yes, there are some days where it feels like we're insane. Some of those moments occasionally happen on our streaming channel, but thanks to Intel and Newegg, we have in store today an overview of performance for not only one, not just two, but three Intel Arc Series A GPUs. I don't know, what one, not two, but three. And we're not just looking at Intel's reference cards, we're looking at the GPUs from a very specific partner, Asrock. Now, these guys have typically been solely an AMD board partner, but Asrock has branched out and given the Arc A series the Asrock Challenger and Phantom Gaming treatment. Now, we are gonna give you a basic idea of how these perform, their pricing, and which one may actually be the right choice for you. Now, at the time of the making of this video, Newegg had some stunning deals on these GPUs. The prices we are going to be listing reflect those sale prices. So what are we looking at, Bob? Well, we're gonna be looking at the Asrock Challenger Arc A380, which retails right now for $100, the A750 coming in at $200, and the Asrock Phantom Gaming A770, which is available in both an 8GB model and a 16GB model for $250 and $300, respectively. Again, your mileage may vary on the price depending on if Newegg sales and when you're actually watching this video. If you're building on a budget, you do not want to sleep on these GPUs, either metaphorically or literally. Seriously, they make terrible pillows. And I'm going to tell you up front, with their performance, they are strong contenders in their respective price bracket. Now, if you want to see us build with one, after this video, we did a full Intel build with Asrock's Phantom Gaming A770, which you can watch over at Robeytech Live and check it out right here. Before we look at the performance numbers, I want to take a quick look at the specs of each one of these GPUs. There is a little bit of a surprise that I want to point out a little later after we look at the performance. First off, we have the Arc A770 Phantom Gaming 16GB OC. It's got 32 Xe cores, it's got a graphics clock of 2200 MHz with 100 MHz overclock. For memory, we've either got an 8GB or 16GB of GDDR6 option and a TDP of 225 watts. Next up is the Arc A750 Challenger D 8GB overclock. It's got 28 Xe cores, a graphics clock of 2200 MHz with 150 MHz overclock. For your memory option, you've got 8GB of GDDR6 and a TDP of 225 watts. And finally, we have the Arc A380 Challenger ITX 6GB OC. It's got 8 Xe cores, a graphics clock of 2250 MHz with a 250 MHz overclock. It's got 6GB of GDDR6 memory and a TDP of 75 watts. That's a lot of numbers. Let's see how we can actually translate those into some useful numbers for you. In our gaming benchmarks, we wanted to keep things pretty basic, but we also wanted to paint a fair and accurate picture of both the A700 series GPUs and the A380. We'll share more details about our testing of the A380 when we get there. But for the A700 series GPUs, we tested at high settings in both 1080p and 1440p resolution. Just a quick note, for the A770, we're gonna be looking at the 16GB version 1. We ran these benchmarks with and without Intel's Xe Super Sampling enabled, or XESS for short, to see how much they would benefit from the technology. In case you're unfamiliar, XESS is an AI-enhanced image upscaler, similar to NVIDIA's Deep Level Super Sampling or AMD's Fidelity FX Super Resolution. You can think of these as like different barbecue sauces that each bring some extra flavor to the party. But the flavor in this case is performance. My personal favorite, sweet baby ray tracing. Speaking of ray tracing, Arc GPUs are absolutely capable of ray tracing, but for our tests, we focused our attention on pure rasterization. As Abraham Lincoln probably said, some rays are better left untraced. So no ray tracing today, friends. Let's start with the A770 and A750 at 1080p numbers. In Cyberpunk 2077 at 1080p, the Phantom Gaming A770 averaged just under 87 frames per second at 86.96, with the A750 hot on its heels at 83.74. When we enabled XDSS at the highest quality setting, we saw some significant gains. The A770 hopped to an average of 101.61, and the A750 skipped ahead to an average of 99.67 frames per second. Not too bad. Now in Modern Warfare 2, the Challenger A750 lived up to its name by taking the lead with averages at 80 frames per second without XDSS. The A770 lagged ever so slightly behind at 77 frames per second. With XDSS, the A750 was the sauce boss, pulling down an average of 94 frames per second while the A770 hit just 80. Again, not a bad look for either GPU. In Forza Horizon 5, the A770 pulls into first position with an average of 88 frames per second, with the A750 at 69 frames per second. This is when things get a little bit weird. In the weirdness, we learn something new, which I always enjoy. Because Forza Horizon 5 has a unique rendering pipeline, upscaling solutions like XDSS or FSR don't really give meaningful performance gains. Bummer or potentially awesome for Forza. Either way, that's how the apples fall. In Shadow of the Tomb Raider, both A700 GPUs average well above 100 frames per second, with the A770 at 121 and the A750 at 116. With XDSS, both the A700 GPUs hovered in the 120s, with the A750 hitting 122 and the A770 averaging 125. Not huge gains, but gains still. Now in Fortnite, we tested on low to match common competitive settings. The A750 and A770 match performance with averages around 246 frames per second. Keep in mind that in the absence of XDSS, we enabled Epic's TSR in its place. So wrapping it up, at 1440p, we saw the A770 and A750 perform around or slightly above 60 frames per second in most of our tests. With Intel's XDSS enabled, we saw enough games that we could say that both GPUs sat comfortably at or around 60 frames per second. The one exception again was Forza Horizon 5 with its unique rendering pipeline. In Fortnite, again at low settings, the A750 ran at 199 and the A770 ran at 205 frames per second, again with TSR enabled. And might I add that this wasn't just playable performance, it was winnable, time and time again. You're probably looking at these titles and asking, wait, when are you gonna put like the A380 through the gauntlet? You know, we did, with the same settings and everything. Honestly, while they weren't necessarily the titles intended for this GPU, one could argue that you could have a largely playable experience in each one of these games. We didn't want the A380 to show up the A700 series, am I right? In truth, we didn't actually want the A380 to get lost in the shadow cast by the performance of the A700 series because it's a fantastic GPU in its own right. So we narrowed the playing field a bit. In Call of Duty at 1080p with basic presets, we saw frame rates average at or around 51 frames per second. But with XDSS, that jumped up to 59. If we really, really wanted to push out as many frames as possible, we could set it to minimum settings. The A380 at that point could jump out as much as 95 frames per second. Now, it may not look amazing, but like Red Green always says, if they don't find you handsome, at least they'll find you handy. Now, keeping things in the shooter vein, the A380 came out to play Fortnite with 100 frames per second at 1080p. Again, this wasn't just playable, we won matches with the A380. And I know you're asking, can it actually launch Cyberpunk 2077's menu, let alone actually play it? Let's be clear, the A380 was not meant to play titles like this, but that doesn't mean we weren't gonna science the crap out of this and see what could be done. At high settings with XDSS enabled, it's like console levels of playable with averages at 44 frames per second. With a few extra tweaks, we see room for some overall improvements, making this experience on the A380 very viable, with the caveat again that that was not intended to work this way. The fact that it's got this far is super impressive. What we're trying to say is that for $100, $100, the A380 lives up to the Asrock naming as it's a challenger. With all these numbers, remember, these are based on the highest preset. Aside from performance enhancements like XDSS and resize bar, which you should be using if you're not already, there is still a lot of room to tweak settings to improve overall frame rates. Also, there's that little detail that I hinted about earlier in this video. Intel has been killing it with refining their drivers for the Arc A-series GPUs, significantly boosting, and I do mean significantly, boosting performance since the launch of their products. Not only that, we've seen this whole overclocking headroom thing that Asrock has been toying with. Have we even seen their final form? Add on top of that, the list of games that supports XeSS seems to be growing longer and longer each and every month. In other words, Intel is making a pretty serious play for budget space GPUs, and adding partners like Asrock only makes that stronger. So here's where we are. Here's my recommendation. Obviously, what we showed you is a small sample of games. It's like one of those appetizer platters with like cheese sticks and spinach and artichoke dip. Really? Who likes spinach and artichoke? Do you like? Okay.
I love it.
Okay. In other words, here's the deal. It's not the whole deal. It's just a taste of a few different things. But largely, what we are seeing and what we've experienced has not only been solid, it just keeps getting better. If you are looking at building a budget-friendly system, we would highly recommend the A770 and A750 for your PC build. From our experiences, the A750 Challenger and the A770 Phantom Gaming GPUs both pumped out some pretty sweet performance at both 1080p and 1440p for a starting price of $200. For some context, in the $200 to $250 price point, you're gonna see some competitions from AMD's Radeon RX 6000 series, ranging from the RX 6500 to the RX 6650 XT. On the NVIDIA side, you might find the RTX 3050, if you're lucky. However, if you're looking to match the VRAM with the Arc A750 and A770, you'd have to look at the RTX 3050 or the RX 6600 or higher to get 8 GB worth. Now let's talk about the Arc A380. There isn't a lot of competition in this price bracket, which is why we're thrilled to see the A380 Challenger here. Now while the A380 might be boxing outside of its weight class with AAA titles, the A380 still provides a largely playable 1080p experience on a GPU in the games that we tested. And may I remind you of this fun fact, you can buy Asrock's Arc A380 offering for $100.
Yeah!
What if, however, you weren't looking to play AAA titles? Well, if you just wanted to build a rig to play games like Stardew Valley with your kids, the A380 could be just the right fit. How about esport titles like Fortnite or Apex Legends? The A380 can bring home the fattest of W's. What if you were really into obscure indie side-scrollers and don't want to spend a whole lot of money on a GPU that you won't even tax? The A380 makes that possible too. We did a little thought experiment when considering what a budget build with the A380 could look like. So, using deals exclusively from Newegg, we pieced together a mini PC featuring Asrock's A380 Challenger ITX GPU. It had a Core i5 13400F CPU, an Asrock B760 Pro RS Micro ATX motherboard, a Deepcool AK400 CPU cooler, 16 gigs of Patriot Viper Black DDR5, the Spadium M450 1TB NVMe drive, the Deepcool CC560 mid-tower case, and a 650 watt 80 plus gold PSU from Thermaltake. All in all, before the deals, this rig would cost you $702.92. But after the deals, and with rebates, it's $672.90. Boom! Budget builds are back. And I didn't even mention the fact that Asrock's Arc A380 Challenger is a single fan, double slot ITX GPU, so you could make this build even smaller if you wanted to. Overall, we're thrilled to see what Intel has conjured up with the Arc Alchemist GPUs and what Asrock has done with this partnership. These were some of our initial thoughts on Asrock's take on the Intel Arc A-series of GPUs. We want to give a huge shout out to Newegg for sponsoring this video and for giving us the opportunity to see how Asrock has taken up the Arc Alchemist mantle and run with it. Now we want to hear what you think, especially if you have one of Asrock's Arc GPUs. How do you like it? Were we fair in our assessment? Or maybe you're curious and want to know more. Whatever the case may be, we want to hear all of that down in the comments below. While you're down there, why don't you go ahead and slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here on Robeytech. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you on the next episode.